When filtering and interacting with a direct query report, end users want the best of both worlds, snappy performance and access to more of the raw data. For those looking for more query performance optimizations without compromising on report interactivity, we're introducing a new public preview feature, Dynamic mQuery Parameters. This new feature allows mQuery parameters to be dynamically updated by the report consumer based on their filter or slicer selections. By giving authors control over how end users' filters gets incorporated into the source query, they can optimize the performance of the query and also allow end users to freely interact with the report using slicers or filters. Let's take a look at the end user experience. You'll see that the end user experience will feel the same as a standard report, meaning that by simply changing a filter, the query parameter is automatically updated based on their selection. Previously, this was something that was not possible at all. Now let's take a look at how we can set this up as the report author. To get started, we'll need to first turn on the preview feature. So be sure to go to preview features and select dynamic mQuery parameters. Note that you may want to check out the documentation in case your scenarios are not supported. Because these are M-based data source scenarios, sources such as SQL Server would not be supported as that relies on native query, not mQuery, to pass the parameters. So once you have this feature switch enabled, let's see the next step of setting up the parameter. So I'm going to go over to my Kusto query and hit Edit Query. Now let's take a look at the parameters that I've set up here. So I have three different parameters, so I'm going to go to Manage Parameters. And you'll see here that we have three that are different types. So two of them are both date time, and then one of them is text. So let's use end time parameter as our example. So I'm going to go into the advanced editor to see how the parameter was referenced in the query. You'll see here that by referencing the parameter in the query, I can optimize for performance because I have full control over how this filter gets incorporated into the source query. Notice that by filtering before I do a more expensive operation, such as the make series count, I'm helping improve the performance. Now let's take a look at the columns that I use to bind to the parameter. So you'll need to create columns that can be used as values as inputs to the parameter. So let's take, for example, the end date time. So I've created a very simple table here that uses the calendar function to just generate the date range, which I'm interested in. So once I have this column created, let's switch now to the modeling tab. So in the modeling tab, let's make sure that we select the column that we want to map to the parameter and then select advanced. And if you scroll down, you'll see this option that says bind to parameter. And let's select the appropriate parameter. Notice that you'll only see the parameters that match the exact data type as the field you're trying to map to. So in this case, we just see the start time and end time parameter, which can be mapped to the current field. Keep in mind that parameters can only be mapped one to one. So if you have two date scenarios, you'll need to create two separate columns for each parameter. And you'll also notice down here, there is a multi-select option. So by default, it's turned off, but if you have a multi-select scenario, you can go ahead and turn this on, but be sure that how you reference the parameter accommodates for that multi-selection. So now that we've mapped the parameter, we can now reuse the mapped field anywhere as a filter or a slicer or even a drill through. But again, keep in mind that because this is single select in this scenario, you'll want to limit it to a single select slicer, as you don't want to cause errors for your end user. And now we can try out some values, and you see here that as the query updates, it's also updating the parameter.